Now let us find the mathematical model of interacting tank. The first tank level is H1, the second tank is level is H2. We are interested in controlling level 2. The flow rate from the first tank to second tank is Q1, as we have seen in the previous case. The area of cross section of first tank is A1, area of cross section of second tank is A2, that we didn't mention earlier, no? I wrote directly. I mentioned, okay. Area of cross section is A2 here. This is A1, A2. The outflow rate here is Q0. Always we are assuming that H1 is greater than H2. Otherwise, what will happen? If H2 is greater than H1, what will happen? Pressure this side will be higher than pressure here. This end can be called as 1, this can be called as 2. If H2 is less than H1, pressure at 2 will be lesser. That's why flow rate will be from first tank to second tank. If second tank level is higher than first tank, the flow rate will be in the reverse direction. That's why we are assuming that H1 is greater than H2. The flow rate to the first tank is Q in. That's all. Therefore, for a mass balance equation, conservation of mass equation, we get mass inflow rate minus mass outflow rate equal to rate of change of mass inside tank. Therefore, if you consider the first tank, what is the equation? Let us assume that the density of liquid entering the tank is rho, leaving the tank is rho, therefore inside is rho, the second tank also rho, outflow rate, in the outflow rate also the density is rho. Therefore, the mass inflow rate equal to rho Q in minus rho Q1 equal to rate of change of mass inside the tank. The volume is A1 H1. Therefore, rate of change of volume is d by dt of rho A1 H1. Rho getting cancelled. Therefore, Q in minus Q1 equal to A1 dH1 by dt. But Q1 equal to what? Q1 equal to B12, because the constant of proportionality is B12, square root of H1 minus H2. Not H1, H1 minus H2. Now, the equation becomes Q in minus B12 square root of H1 minus H2 equal to A1 dH1 by dt. But this is a non-linear relation, that's why we cannot obtain Laplace transform. So let us linearize the given equation. To linearize that, we have to consider Q1 equal to B12 square root of H1 minus H2. So take ln of Q1 equal to ln of B12 plus 1 by 2 ln of H1 minus H2. Partially differentiate on both sides, we'll get dou Q1 upon Q1 equal to 0 plus 1 by 2. Let us assume that the difference is a single variable. H1 minus H2 can be assumed as another variable, say H. So we can write 1 by H1 minus H2. Or we have to substitute H equal to H1 minus H2, then we have to replace. So instead we can write directly 1 by 2 H1 minus H2, dou H1 minus H2, dou Q1 by Q1 nominal equal to 0 plus dou H1 by H2, dou H1 minus H2 to H1 nominal minus H2 nominal. Let us assume that it is true at a nominal operating point. At nominal operating point, this is true for small changes. Therefore, delta Q1 upon Q1 nominal equal to 0 plus, this becomes delta H1 minus H2. Now we have to replace upon 2H1 nominal minus H2 nominal, Q1, Q1 upon Q1 nominal equal to H1 minus H2 upon 2 times H1 nominal minus H2 nominal. That's all. Therefore, Q1 equal to H1 minus H2 multiplied by Q1 nominal upon H1 nominal minus H2 nominal 2 times. That's all. That's all. Or we can write Q1 equal to H1 minus H2. This can be called as, R, because Q is like current, H is like potential. That's why it can be called as R12. Therefore, it is constant. Everything is constant. That's why it can be called as R12. Therefore, Q1 equal to H1 minus H2 divided by R12. This can be substituted in place of in the equation 1. This can be substituted in the equation 1. Therefore, the equation 1, Q in nominal plus Q in minus Q1 minus Q1 small q1 equal to A1 d by dt of, what is that first equation? H1. H1 nominal plus H1. These two are getting cancelled. These two are getting cancelled because these two are equal. Therefore, Q in minus Q1 equal to A1 dH1 by dt. This is also equal to 0. Derivative of constant. Q1 minus Q1 equal to A1 dH1 by dt. Q1, what we obtained? H1 minus H2 divided by R12. Therefore, we can substitute Q in minus H1 minus H2 upon R12 equal to A1 dH1 by dt. Now take Laplace transform on both sides, you will get Q in of S minus H1 of S upon R12 plus H2 of S upon R12 equal to A1 S H1 of S, assuming zero initial conditions. Assuming zero initial conditions. Now bring all H1 one side, you will get and multiply by R12, you will get R12 A1 S plus 1 H1 of S equal to R12 Q in of S plus H2 of S plus H2 of S. This is equation A. Similarly, we can find for second tank. What is that? Q1 minus Q0 equal to, similarly, A2 dH2 by dt. But Q1 can be replaced by Q1 nominal plus Q1 minus Q0 nominal minus Q0 equal to A2 d by dt of H2 nominal plus H2. These two are getting cancelled. This and this getting cancelled. They are equal. Since it is constant, that's why this also becomes 0. These two are getting cancelled. Therefore, Q1 minus Q0 equal to A2 dH2 by dt. Q1 can be replaced by this relation, that is H1 minus H2 upon R12 minus Q0 equal to what? By linearizing outflow rate, that is Q0 equal to B0 square root of H2. From this, we can linearize this, we will get, what you will get? Q0 equal to H2 divided by R0. This is by linearization you got Q0 equal to H2 by R0. If you substitute that here, you will get H2 by R0 equal to A2 dH2 by dt. Take Laplace transform on both sides, you will get H1 of S upon R12 minus H2 of S R12 minus, am I correct? H2 of S upon R0 equal to A2S H2 of S. So bring all H2 one side, you will get and multiply on both sides by R12 and R0, you will get R12. R12, multiply on both sides by R12, you will get R12 A2 S H2 of S. You bring this H2 on the right hand side, you will get H2 of S here plus R12 upon R0, because there is no R12, H2 of S equal to H1 of S. We got the relation for H1 of H2 and H2 in terms of H1 you are getting. Okay. Here you are having relation for H1. Now we can substitute the value of H1 here. So one more step let us write. One more step let us write. R12 A2S plus 1 plus R12 upon R0 multiplied by H2 of S equal to H1 of S. Let it be B. By using A and B, we can find, we can eliminate H1. R12, R12 A1S plus 1 A2S plus 1 plus R12 upon R0. Now we multiplied by H2 of S equal to R12 R12 Q in of S plus H2 of S So if you bring all H2 of S one side, you will get and find H2 of S upon Q in of S, you will get R12 upon R12 A1S plus 1 multiplied by R12 A2S plus 1 plus R12 upon R0 plus 1. This plus 1 because of this H2. This is the expression for interacting tank. Interacting tank. This is the mathematical model for interacting tank. Already I told you that we are interested in H2. That's why we are eliminating H1. We are not interested in H1. We are interested in H2 only. That's why we eliminated H1 from the expression.